Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you some of the notable blockchain security issues and would be drawing light to the fundamental question of, is blockchain really secure? So let's get started. But before we start, we must understand that blockchain security primarily depends on the type of blockchain we are using, as each type has different implications regarding the privileges for participation and data access. And depending on the privileges of the participation, blockchain networks can be divided primarily as private or public. Public blockchain networks are open and could allow any user to join while ensuring the anonymity of the participants. These primarily leverage internet-connected computers for validating transactions alongside achieving consensus. On the other hand, private blockchain networks depend on identity for confirming membership and access privileges. In addition, they allow the participation of only familiar organizations into the system. This understanding of security concerns with different types of blockchain networks promotes better scope for learning about blockchain security issues. If you are not already familiar with these concepts, I would recommend you to watch my video on this topic. Link is there in the description below. Further, the evaluation of type of blockchain network suited to your business goal can help you in making better decisions when it comes to privacy and security. For example, private and permission networks could have tighter controls for regulatory and compliance concerns, and on the contrary, public and permissionless networks can empower you with better distribution and decentralization. Next, before jumping into blockchain security issues, let me first answer the fundamental question of, is blockchain really secure, as it will help you get broader perspective on the subject. Now, we all have heard that description of blockchain technology points out towards cryptography, immutability, and decentralization. With this cryptographic security and assurance that no one can modify your data without the knowledge of other participants, blockchain definitely seems to be secure, and without a doubt, blockchain can give you a tamper-proof account of transactions. However, this does not mean that blockchain is not vulnerable to cyber attacks and security frauds. People with malicious intent could exploit the blockchain security vulnerabilities to their advantage, and many such examples of blockchain attacks have made the news from time to time. Some of the most troublesome events which revealed the security risk of blockchain can be summarized by studying these recent incidents. Number 1. Exploited code. This event showcased privacy and security issues of decentralized autonomous organization, or DAO's, blockchain, wherein programmers were fixing an issue with regards to code malfunctioning on the system, and at this time, an unknown attacker began draining the DAO of Ether, which was collected from the sale of its token. There was more than $60 million of Ether stolen in just a few hours, and the blow itself was quite hard for DAO as it accounted for almost one-third of its total value. Here, if you study this case carefully, you'll discover that the code exploitation served as the primary culprit for this event and rightfully showed the vulnerability of the blockchain infrastructure. Number 2. Missing keys. There have been cases wherein bitcoins have been stolen. A prominent one happened from a Hong Kong-based cryptocurrency exchange, Bitfinex. The amount stolen was close to $72 million, and it proved out that stolen private keys or personal digital signatures were the most probable cause of the event. Number 3. Hacking employee system. Another example of blockchain security issues is Bithumb, which is one of the biggest cryptocurrency exchanges for Bitcoin and Ethereum and is based out in South Korea. In this incident, hackers were able to dig into data of around 30,000 users alongside stealing Bitcoin worth $32 million. And interestingly, the core servers were intact and a compromised employee computer was the primary culprit. So, we must understand that if an attacker gets the access to the network node and if the internal measures are not considered, it can prove to be a costly mistake for a business. If you want to learn more about these incidents, links for individual case studies have been shared in the description below, so feel free to check them out. Further, in all, we can say, based on all these aspects, that blockchain isn't so secure after all. Therefore, it makes highly important for us to understand every detail that influences blockchain security. So, now let's take a look at some of the blockchain security vulnerabilities and issues that you must be aware of. Number 1. 51% attacks. A 51% attack refers to an attack where a group of miners control more than 50% of the network's mining hash rate or computing power. If an attacker has achieved this, the attackers would be able to prevent new transactions from gaining confirmation, allowing them to halt payment between some or all of the network users. And also, do note that they would be able to reverse transactions that were completed while they were in control of the network, meaning they could easily double spend coins. Further, it is important to note that an attacker would almost certainly not be able to create new coins or alter old blocks during the phase of the attack. But you can say that 50% attack probably can destroy major cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, and even if it is sorted in time, it can be proved highly damaging. In 2018, three renowned cryptocurrency platforms experienced the issue from 51% attacks. Three platforms were Ethereum Classic, Zencash, and Verge. Furthermore, some of the major enterprises have lost almost $20 million in just 2020 due to 51% attacks. As a company, if you have to avoid blockchain security issue due to 51% attacks, then you must implement certain control measures. For example, you can improve monitoring of mining pools and ensure that a higher hash rate is refrained by proof-of-work consensus mechanisms. Number 2. Routing attacks. Although one can run a blockchain node anywhere on this earth, the nodes that compose the network today are far from being spread uniformly around the globe. As all blockchain networks and applications depend on massive volume of data transfer in real time. All an attacker needs to do here is to intercept data during the course of its transmission to internet service providers. For example, an attacker can use routing attacks to partition the network into two or more disjoint components, and by preventing nodes within a component to communicate with the nodes outside of it, the attacker forces the creation of parallel blockchains. Further, after the attack stops, all blocks mined within the smaller component will be discharged together with all included transactions and miners' revenue. For just Bitcoin, it is proven that most of the traffic exchange between Bitcoin nodes traverses to only few ISPs. Indeed, the results indicate that 60% of all possible Bitcoin connections cross 3 ISPs. In other words, 3 ISPs can see 60% of the world's Bitcoin traffic. Further, the dangerous aspect of routing attacks in blockchain security lies in their anonymity. The blockchain participants cannot even find out the threat of routing attacks easily, as everything appears normal at the user's end. Routing attacks are generally employed for leaking out confidential data or extracting monetary benefits without alarming network participants. Therefore, it is quite clear that routing attacks can be detrimental, as they could impose considerable damage before detection. Number 3. Blockchain endpoint vulnerabilities. Now, endpoint vulnerabilities are critical because of where they take place, which in most cases is at the time and place humans and blockchains meet. Simply put, an endpoint could be anywhere an individual is accessing any form of data. And since most hackers know there's no use in attempting to guess an end user's key, they spend a lot of time trying to steal them. And the best chance of obtaining keys is to attack the weakest point in the entire system, which in most cases is a personal computer or a mobile device. Also, do note here that the process of accessing blockchain in order to receive data is what makes endpoints so vulnerable. In a system, all endpoints provide a malicious attacker the opportunity they need to get nasty code in or out. The difference is that some are hard to crack and some are not. But once a device is exploited, hackers can piggyback off the credentials of high access users in order to do the most amount of damage to a network system. Number 4. Vendor risks. Quite often, companies looking to deploy third-party blockchain apps and platforms are not aware of security risk associated with faulty or exposed vendor. And it is not uncommon for vendor solutions to have limited focus on security measures with weak security controls on their system, flawed code, and even personal vulnerabilities that can easily expose their clients' blockchain credentials to unauthorized users. This threat is especially relevant when discussing products that involve the use of smart contracts, since an organization's entire operation and policies can be housed as a smart contract on a blockchain. A vulnerability of this magnitude has the potential to cause major damage. Number 5. Transaction privacy leakage. In public blockchain networks, transactions are open and transparent, and their architecture makes every transaction traceable as well. The publicity of this data on the network keeps the information synchronized and allows reaching consensus among distributed nodes. At the same time, there are some privacy risk concerns associated with the public data, wherein transactions contain sensitive information about their issuers. In some blockchain applications, such as Internet of Things or mobile crowdsourcing, transaction privacy leakage can cause critical issues. The indirect privacy leakage is possible through disclosure of transaction content, and namely the analysis of transaction graph could uncover the correlation between different transaction addresses. This correlation could further lead to revealing users' identity from any additional data collected elsewhere. The most popular solution to transaction leakage is implementing a mixing service. And upon activation, this service will allow several users to make transactions simultaneously with multiple inputs and outputs, and because of this, the transaction inputs won't be able to map to their corresponding outputs. Number 6. Phishing attacks. We all know that phishing is one of the most common baiting techniques used by hackers. It is basically a scamming attempt to obtain credentials of a user. Hackers send emails to wallet key owners by posing as authentic and authoritative sources. These emails request information about user credentials through fake hyperlink, and when hackers get these credentials and sensitive information of a user, the user himself as well as the blockchain network are open to subsequent attacks. And just so you know, there were about 100,000 phishing attacks reported just in the year 2020. The best way to avoid such attack is to educate wallet owners and key stakeholders of the network about countermeasures to avoid phishing. Lastly, as a conclusion, I'd like to say that adopting new technologies always come with a fear of unknown. While blockchain-based solutions continue to provide customers with high level of security and transparency, the responsibility falls on product designers to begin considering security from day one. This awareness of vulnerabilities in blockchain security is essential to create better networks and systems. Furthermore, the technical advancements such as AI-based solutions for infrastructure, transaction, and code analysis can advance new trends and measures in blockchain security. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.